Welcome back to the Friday Night Sports Show. He's AJ, I'm Mike. Now we're taking a look at the Wyoming Valley Conference and the biggest schools in the league.
Yeah, Mike, both Wilkes-Barre and Hazleton area in the middle of good seasons in Class 6A. Each team coming in 4-3 to their showdown on Friday night. Certainly a matchup that we might see again in November. And the Cougars moving the ball early. Tyler Wolf with the pump fake. Looks like he's going to take off and run, but instead fires one into Ryan Mattias, who darts upfield and gets into Wolfpack territory. Then how about this? The handoff to Mattias as he's falling, able to pitch the ball back to Matt Bookman, who takes it from there and scores the touchdown. Hazleton up 8-0 after the two-point conversion. Second quarter, Wilkes-Barre strikes back. Javon McClary, the quick pass out to the flat for Javon Goodwin. He gets the edge and finds the end zone, but Hazleton area improves to 5-3 with a 29-10 win.
In the back mountain, Dallas hosting Crestwood. Mountaineers already with a 20-0 lead and the defense looking to keep it that way. In the second, A.J. Fife laying the lumber. That helped stall a Crestwood drive, and the Mountaineers would lead 20-0 at the break. Third quarter, a lengthy, impressive drive by the Dallas offense ends with a 2-yard touchdown run by Parker Ballesta. Dallas improving to 4-2 with a 41-14 win.
And Wyoming Valley West making the trip out west to face Williamsport. Millionaires already up 7-0 early when they add another touchdown. Nasir Hennigan with the carry from 14 yards out. He gets in, and that doubles the lead. Later in the first, Billtown keeping it on the ground. Lajeer Whaley breaking a tackle, races into the secondary. That's a 34-yard touchdown to put the Millionaires up by 3 scores, and they didn't let up in the second. Now George Whaley going deep over the middle. Yazir Slaughter, he's going to make a nice over-the-shoulder grab. That's an 83-yard touchdown. Williamsport dominates en route to a 40-7 win.
One more from the Wyoming Valley Conference. Berwick hosting Pittston, and in the first quarter, handoff on 3rd and 1 to Ben Knorr. Knorr breaks off a nice gain right in front of our cameras, pushed out of bounds, puts the Bulldogs in business. Next play, 1st and goal, Knorr takes the pitch. He would score. Knorr would score. A 7-0 Berwick advantage. Later in the quarter, Matthew Lonchinski dropping back, sees his man, AJ. Look at this catch by Dre Wilk in the back of the end zone.
Fantastic.
It's a very difficult catch. Looked pretty easy. Extra point, no good. Berwick up 13-0. Still in the first. 30 seconds left in the quarter to be exact. Handoff to Wilk right up the gut for another Berwick Bulldogs touchdown. Berwick getting the win. 34-7 is the final.
All right, now moving to District 11, checking in on a couple of our ranked teams in Schuylkill County. 8th-ranked Pottsville with a tall task on the road.
Crimson Tide rolling in to face Northwestern Lehigh, which came into this game unbeaten. Crimson Tide led 7-0, but the Tigers' Justin Holmes gets in from the 1-yard line to tie it up at 7. In the second, more Northwestern Lehigh. Cade Christopher gets in from the 4-yard line. 2-point try, no good. Tigers take a 13-7 lead, and later in the quarter, Holmes again. Again from 4 yards out, Pottsville falls on the road, 22-14, the final.
A good fight, though, by the Crimson Tide against a very good team. And third-ranked North Schuylkill at home to face Salisbury. There's Wally Hall, head coach, and his team on a roll in this one. First possession, Jake Hall going up top to Joey Flail, able to out-jump the defender for the touchdown. Spartans up 7-0. Defense was swarming all night. Quarterback here for Salisbury with nowhere to go. Several players in on that sack, including number 79, Robbie Whites, part-time running back. And Josh Chawansky became the all-time leading rusher in Spartans history on this night, surpassing the record previously held by Jaden Livey. Here, Chawansky with a receiving touchdown off a swing pass. North Schuylkill stays unbeaten with a 42-0 shutout win.
So they're for real, huh?
I think North Schuylkill is most definitely for real. Look forward to see how they do as we move closer to the playoffs.
No question.
Now next up, we're going to head out to Central Pennsylvania for a look around District 4.
Jersey Shore trying to stay undefeated. Southern Columbia trying to build up a new winning streak. And starting from scratch, we'll have their highlights straight ahead. But first, sights and sounds of the Lakeland marching band.